guys while I'm on vacation. I thought of a video idea that I thought would be pretty cool. Maybe to you guys, but definitely for me. So if you guys enjoy, leave a like on the video. If you do enjoy this video, subscribe. Obviously, that's always good. But in today's video, we're going to be looking at my subscribers, you guys, you amazing, amazing, amazing people's favorite NBA players. Now, how I got this information is because already picked. It's already over. I should probably put closed over that video so people know it's not going on anymore. But again, congratulations to that person. It was a really great time getting out that person out. But I asked the people in order to enter into the sort of giveaway that in order to get to the giveaway, they had to comment down below their favorite NBA player. And as I'm filming this video, which is should be about maybe almost a week later, is 158 people have commented on this one video, which is the most I've ever had on my channel. I think even my first video, which has give or take 20,000 views, this video has more comments on it, maybe even more likes. If I'm not mistaken, it has a bunch of likes too. So I very much, again, appreciate you guys for that. That's it brings a smile on my face, and I really do appreciate it when you guys give love back to me. It makes me feel, you know, wanted, which is great. So yeah, there's 158 comments. A lot of people commented down below their favorite players, and I was reading through some of them while I was, you know, picking the winner randomly. And a lot of you guys have a lot of really cool reasons why some players are your favorites. Some people just picked, you know, their favorite player because they're really good at basketball, which is always good. So I thought it'd be kind of cool to pick out and read out some of these. Obviously, I will not be saying names because, you know, privacy of people, and I can't just obviously go through and ask people, hey, can I do this? Hey, can I say your name? This, that, and the other. So everyone's going to be anonymous. But if you do find yours, and you can comment down below, hey, that was mine. You know, you can go into more detail about it if you want to or not. But I think this would be kind of cool to just sit back, relax, and listen to some basketball players that have been around in the league. So hopefully you guys enjoy this video. So I'm just going to be reading them, and I guess I'll just do newest first. And let's get started. If I don't see like a very large explanation, I'll probably just skip past it and just read some of the more higher explained ones. But I'm seeing so far Zach LaVine. That's pretty good. It's spelled wrong, but that's pretty cool. My favorite player of all time is Kareem Abdul-Jabbar. That skyhook is unguardable. Yes, very true. Kareem is, in my opinion, top three all time. Probably the greatest center of all time. I don't think he's the best. I think Shaq is probably still talent-wise better, but greatness-wise and career-wise, Kareem is untouchable, that's for sure. This person said, my favorite players have to be Kyle Korver. As a Hawks fan, that 2014-15 run was probably the most interested I've ever been in basketball, and that's a big part. And he was a big part of that. I don't know why he said plural for players, but I guess his favorite players include Kyle Korver, I guess. That's really cool. Yeah, that 2014 Hawks team was crazy. I remember, this probably isn't a good memory for you, but I remember everyone saying, oh, you know, the Hawks are going to take out LeBron James, and the Hawks are, you know, they have their number, blah, 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 and then LeBron beat that team in like 5 or 6, which is really kind of sad, but the Hawks team was amazing. The Hawks have always been a very interesting team to me. Kyle Korver, one of the best three-point shooters of all time, that team with Joe Johnson, Josh Smith, Al Horford, Jeff Teague, that team was stacked, that team was really good, and I think they had Mike Budenholzer as their team as well. The coach as well, and I think the team also had a young Dennis Schroeder on that team. Man, that team was stacked. Probably would have won the East maybe that year if they didn't run into LeBron. Same thing with that Toronto Raptors team that was in that year. Again, probably would have gotten a little bit easier if LeBron wasn't there, but hey, that Atlanta Hawks team won like 60 plus games if I'm not mistaken. My favorite NBA player is Damian Lillard. That's a really good one. My favorite player is Kobe Bryant. That's probably going to be so many Kobe Bryants. That's for sure. He's awesome. Because he's clutch and because he has that Mamba mentality. Well, my friend, he has that Mamba mentality because he is the creator of the Mamba mentality. So that's very true. We have another Kobe. My favorite player of all time is Kobe Bean Bryant because he was such an inspiration to me and a GOAT. That is very true. 100% facts. Finals, which are going on right now as you guys are watching these videos. Bears, and man, just the way he got traded. When he got traded to, you know, Minnesota, took them to the playoffs, but he was apparently the problem. Then traded to Philly. Philly made, you know, a great run in the playoffs, but only lost to a, in my opinion, a very lucky shot in Philly, and Philly probably should have won that series, honestly, but didn't happen. But apparently Jimmy Butler was still a problem, and now he's in Miami in his first NBA Finals. He's now a conference champion, which is awesome. He definitely deserves it. Nothing but love for Jimmy Butler. I love his competitiveness, and if being competitive means you're toxic, then hey, I guess that's Jimmy Butler. Mavericks of all time, and this is only his second season. Potential wise, like, he has it all. He has the complete game. All he can really knock on him is for defense, but that obviously will come in time with, you know, slowing the game down, you know, learning the NBA and stuff like that. It'll come. But yeah, Luka, Mavericks are extremely lucky, that's for sure. This guy said Cameron Payne, and that's a great pick. My favorite player is definitely Kevin Garnett. He is such a dominant player in the Wolves. Best player of all time. Go Wolves. And keep up the great work. Thank you, my guy. Yeah, Kevin Garnett, definitely the best player in Wolves history. MVP. He won with the Timberwolves. Yeah, that team just needed a little bit more help. Him and Sam Cassell. That team definitely needed another guy on that squad. Otherwise, Kevin Garnett probably would have willed that team to a championship, if I'm not mistaken. But definitely need more help. But yeah, KG is a great player, one of the best power forwards of all time, one of the most underrated players of all time, just because, you know, him teaming up with Boston sort of like, I don't know, tarnished his career. I mean, obviously, if he won a championship and with the Timberwolves, it would have meant more than him winning a title with the Boston Celtics. So even then, you know, a lot of young guys don't really realize how great Kevin Garnett was. Oh, this guy also said Kevin Garnett, but this is because I'm a diehard Celtics fan. Out of energy and heart he brings into games is unmatched. Marcus Smart's mentality reminds me of him. Yeah, KG, even on the Celtics, was an amazing player for a couple years there before he got a little bit on the older side, but that's very true. That's very true. My all-time favorite player is Devin Booker, and I liked him since he joined the NBA, and he might not be on a good team, but I like how he plays, yeah. That'll definitely change very soon. Obviously, their young core starting to blossom, as we saw in the bubble. Winning all 8 of their bubble games, just missing out on the playoffs due to circumstances of other teams. So they do have a pretty good pick this year, and if they decide to trade that pick to bring in another a player for Devin Booker to play along with, that'd be awesome. I think maybe that pick and maybe Kelly Oubre will get that job done, whatever player they decide that to be. I would really like to see them get like a good sort of 3-and-D wing player. I think Devin Booker, I don't think the team really needs a better point guard, because Devin Booker is obviously a very ball-dominant player. They already have their big man of the future with DeAndre Ayton, so I think having a really good forward to play alongside them will be an amazing step up to that team. I've got to say my favorite player is Jordan, and due to his mindset and always winning and accepting nothing less, is a real motivator. Yeah, that's the first Jordan. I'm actually surprised that's the first time we saw Michael Jordan's name. MJ, yeah, definitely the GOAT for sure. My favorite player is Taco Fall. He is underrated and just a different breed in general. Yeah, he built different, that's for sure. Taco Fall, man, he's crazy good. He'll get there. Obviously, you need to knock on wood for this, but just need to, you know, worry about injuries being that lanky and stuff like that. Definitely need to worry about that, but I think he'll be totally fine. Being a really good role player, I don't think he's going to be an amazing player, obviously, due to the way he's built. Schroeder, that's funny because I said his name. My favorite player of all time has to be Michael Jordan, since he got me into basketball, and he's the GOAT from mindset to skill to impact on and off the court. Thank you for the offer. Okay, yeah, that's awesome. Yeah, Michael Jordan. Larry Bird, the first time I'm seeing Larry Legend. Kobe Bryant, my favorite player has to be Kobe Bryant, because he was born in the early, because I was born in the early 2000s, and course. Definitely one of a fan favorite. It's definitely sad what happened to him, you know, not being able to sort of finish out his last season. I think it would have been really cool if Vince obviously would have came back for next season, got a chip, this, that, and the other, but, you know, he played the game he wanted to, and that's all you can ask for. My favorite player is Tony Kukoc. That's awesome. LeBron James, that's the first time we're seeing LeBron James. ASMballeR, my favorite player has to be Larry Bird. In my personal opinion, skillful in the league in his prime. I love the Vince man. That's awesome. Yeah, Larry Legend. He's definitely one of my favorite players of all time. Is he underrated? To an extent, yeah. Some people put him down in like the lower tiers of like their top 10 list, which being top 10 isn't bad at all, but definitely at Larry Bird's peak due to injuries and things like that. I definitely has had one of the highest peaks of any player I've ever seen. As a player, just by himself, he is just so capable of so much, being sort of like a Luka Doncic type player, but also played amazing defense. Yeah, like I said, having some injury problems definitely set him back to not reaching that sort of like my Magic Johnson, where it was like over a span of time, he was really great. But I think Larry Bird at one point in time was just the better player overall. My favorite player of all time has to be Andre Iguodala. He got me into basketball around 8 years old when he was on the Sixers. I was born a Sixers fan. Fall in love with the organization. I was just thinking about if Andre Iguodala was so good. He was such a good scorer in Philadelphia, and then I think after Philly he went to Denver, did he not? And then after Denver he went to the Warriors. So yeah, he was on the Warriors for a long the Sixers for a long time. And yeah, again, one of my favorite players of all time has to be Andre Iguodala as well. Very underrated. Allen Iverson, great one. My favorite player of all time is Damian fan. I've been watching since 2 years ago, ever since I found your ASMR My League videos. You helped my anxiety a lot. Thanks for doing the giveaway. Thank you, dude. Yeah, I mean, I always get this sort of feeling that, obviously I'm doing ASMR videos, but I feel like a lot of people just watch my videos for, like, the basketball sort of content of things, but I would really love to think that my channel helps a lot more people out than just through, you know, entertainment, which is great. I love doing that, and I also love just building a chemistry between you guys and getting to know me more, which is awesome. But, you know, anxiety is a real thing. I struggle with it all the time. That's why I've, you know, I found to love ASMR in the first place. So, and why I made this channel in the first place was to make, you know, somewhat relaxing content, as loud cars drive by all the time. But it's one of the reasons why I made this channel, is to make, you know, basketball content, but whispered and relaxing, and to help people, you know, sleep and forget about their days and things like that. So I really at least try to feel like I'm helping people through, you know, whatever they're going through, not just doing entertainment, which is great, but I really hope to do more than that. But yeah, thank you so much. That was very heartfelt. LeBron James, that's a good one. My favorite player of all time is none other than Will Be Free. Holy crap. Will Be Free, that's awesome. Rodman, because of his mindset on the court and his amazing ability to rebound. That's a really good one too. That's one I don't think I've ever heard that one before, actually. Dennis Rodman, someone being someone's favorite player. My favorite player is Kobe. Yeah, that's a good one as well. My favorite player is Kemba Walker. Quick story, I didn't like basketball a lot before, but I was listening to music and there was a song called Kemba Walker. I've never heard that song before. I love that song. It was my favorite, and I wanted to know who Kemba was. I've seen highlights and loved his game, and now I'm a Kemba Walker, a Kemba bandwagon, lol. He is one of the most unselfish point guards in the league, and still a bucket, that is for sure. Yeah, Kemba's great. Obviously, you know, I struggled a lot in these last sort of games for the Celtics, going on in that series. I mean, he still played really good, but, you know, defensively, definitely struggles a little bit being an undersized guard, but offensively he has the capability of being the best player on the floor at on any teams on any given night. So Kim is amazing, that's definitely for sure. Allen Iverson, favorite player of all time is easily Derrick Rose. Just wish I could have seen his full potential. Yeah, Derrick Rose is probably a lot of people's favorite player as well. Steph Curry. I thought the comments were going to be bombarded with Steph Curry's, but this is the first one we've actually seen. My favorite player of all time is Blake Griffin, because I'm a Clippers fan and I watched him play, and he was so fun to watch. He was super energetic and gave his all. Lob City was the best, man. Yeah, honestly, like, Lob City made me want to be a fan of them too. Like him, Blake, Chris Paul, JJ, DeAndre Jordan, like, the whole squad was crazy, man. Tracy McGrady. That's nice. Yeah, injuries just totally derailed them, that's for sure. Derrick Rose. Yep, another one. Another Blake Griffin. Wow, there's a lot of Blake Griffins. My favorite player is Duncan Robinson. Wow, because he went to Michigan, and that is my favorite college. I also like him because he's one of the most improbable players of all time. He became one of the best shooters in the league in a very underrated athleticism. I don't know how Miami even found this kid. Just literally a walking 3-point shot. Like, this dude is crazy good. I've seen, like, that clip of him, like, shooting that 3-point shot. Like, he literally just instantly catches the ball and just shoots it so fast. It's crazy. Yeah, Duncan is just, he's really cool. We have another Kemba Walker and a Hornets fan. My favorite player is Jokic. That's a good one as well. Steve Nash. Wow, I love that. Another Damian. Wow, I wonder how I'm getting all these Damian guys. Now, obviously, Damian's probably my favorite player of all time as well, so that's really cool. Michael Jordan, Kobe Bryant. I'm trying to see. This guy asked who my favorite player was. I just said probably Damian Lillard, probably all time. I mean, there's Damian, and then probably Kobe. Kobe was actually my first favorite player ever, because he was the first really player I really watched. The Lakers were actually my first team I was actually, like, a really big fan of. Just getting introduced to basketball, because whenever you're ever introduced to basketball, you're always somewhat of a fan of the best team at that time. So that's why there's so many, you know, Warrior and Curry fans running around now. And then LeBron, probably up there as well. Brandon Roy, for me, as a Blazer fan, is a big one for me, too. D-Wade, someone's Carlos Boozer. Well, that's a really good one. I always loved game and eye arcing shot. That's pretty dope. Michael Jordan again, Kobe Bryant again, Kevin Herter, that's definitely a new one. Jrue Holiday / Jimmer Fredette. Jrue, because I've been a Pels fan since rookie AD, and Jimmer because I'm a massive BYU fan. Nice. Kyrie Irving, another Kobe. Jimmy Butler. Wow, that's cool. Kevin Durant, another player I have not seen a lot of names of, and another player I've not seen a lot of names of, James Harden. I don't know why, but James Harden is one of my favorite players in the league. He's an awesome shooter and also a good ball handler. That's really cool. Brandon Roy, that's a good one. My favorite NBA player is Dame Dime. Yeah, that's a good one. Carmelo Anthony. He played for my Nuggets, and he is amazing, and he was amazing on the Knicks. Hope he keeps playing good on your Blazers. Hope the Blazers dominate next season. Well, we're gonna need some help if that's gonna be a thing. We're definitely gonna need the help of the basketball gods of finally not having a season that's just injury ridden, which is just throughout Blazer history always a thing, so you're never gonna get past that. Dirk Nowitzki, that's a good one. Tracy McGrady, that's a good one. Russell Westbrook, I was feeling we're gonna get more of those, but not T-Mac, Carmelo, Rajon Rondo. My favorite NBA player is Rondo. That's awesome. Kobe Bean for sure. My favorite player is Manu Ginobili, and that's awesome. Black Mamba, Donovan Mitchell. He's got handles, can dunk, can shoot. I love you, ASMballeR, and watch almost every video. I love you too, man. James Harden, Rajon Rondo. There's two Rajon Rondos on this list. That's so awesome. You guys are great. You guys are really cool. Larry Legend, Paul George, Indiana. This one superstar, but without the system, he's just an average player, so that's kind of crazy. Tyler Hero, that's a really good one. Tyler Hero. Patty Mills or George Gervin, wow. Another Giannis, KD, King James in Miami, yeah. Blake Griffin again, wow, you guys really like Blake Griffin. Chris Paul. Isaiah Thomas from the Detroit Pistons, that's a great one. Russell Westbrook from his 2017 season made me love basketball. Yeah, Russell Westbrook, man, he's a dog for sure. D Wade, Kobe Bryant again, Zach LaVine, wow, a lot of Zach LaVines. LeBron, Steve Nash. My favorite player right now is Giannis, and my all-time is Michael Redd. That's pretty sick. Yeah, Michael Redd, man, he was one of the best scorers in the league at one point, man. Michael Jordan, Vince Carter, LeBron James, Kobe Bryant, LeBron, there's a lot of LeBron and Kobe's. I think those are definitely the top two guys so far. Allen Iverson, Michael Porter Jr. The reason why is because he went to Missouri, and I'm a big homer. Yeah, that's really cool. Yeah, he used to play up here in the Pacific Northwest, up in Seattle. Jimmy Butler, Tony Parker, that's a new one. Rodman, Curry, James Harden, Kobe Bryant, Kristaps Porzingis, that's a cool one. Jeremy Lin, that's the first Jeremy Lin one. 3 years ago, it would have been Iron Man Wesley Matthews, but Blazers let him down. So it's got to be Damian Lillard or Yusuf Nurkic. I wouldn't say the Blazers let him down. I think it's because he got hurt. He was a dog. The dude was like a 15 point per game scorer, one of the best perimeter defenders in the league at that point in time, one of the best 3-point shooters at the time. Yeah, I love Iron Man, he's dope, but yeah, definitely Dame or Yusuf is a good one too. Jordan, Goran Dragic, who had a really good breakout playoff sort of year this year with Miami. Grant Hill, I'm a huge Duke fan, I think he was good. That's literally for sure. People were saying Grant Hill is the next Michael Jordan. He was going to be the next great player before those injuries. I'm trying to see any ones we haven't seen before. Tracy McGrady again. That's pretty much all the ones I could see. But yeah, hopefully you guys enjoyed this sort of shorter video. You guys are awesome. I love talking to you guys, hearing your guys' opinions on basketball and things like that. You guys are just really fun and awesome and amazing. So so much for participating in that little giveaway, I guess. Again, congratulations to the winner. And yeah, hopefully maybe one of these days we can do another one of these videos where I ask you guys a question, you guys can just answer it down in the comments. I can make a video off of it. That'd be really cool. But yeah, I'd have to say probably Kobe or LeBron were the most named ones, and maybe even Michael Jordan, but there were a lot of Rondos. That was pretty surprising. Kevin Garnett was a pretty interesting name as well. And a lot of Zach LaVine and Blake Griffin fans, so a lot of you guys have probably grown up watching, like, dunk highlights and